Channel, man, and the beat for the intro is provided by Coats Beats. There's a link in the description below that's going to take you directly to downloadpass.com where you can find this particular mixtape with this particular beat on it, man, and the contact information via Twitter. And if you holler at him to get some beats, tell him I sent you. But anyway, on to today's reply. And today's reply is to that J. Cole in Dreamsville, Revenge of the Dreamers, man, in which this is a mixtape to showcase J. Cole's artists, in which J. Cole went on and got a deal through Interscope for his own record label, in which that's good shit. And as I went through and listened to all of these songs, every single one of his artists can spit. Now, my favorite songs off of this mixtape were that Motion Picture by Omen, that Lit by Bass that had J. Cole and K. Quick on it, and my favorite was the title track, man, the J. Cole's Revenge of the Dreamers. Now, these artists are good, man. I definitely think that this team could rival a lot of other teams out there in the damn music industry, man, on every musical aspect of it except for the buzz. Like, not one of these individual artists have their own buzz. Not one has their individual promotion up to par right now. Like, this is the first I've heard of a bunch of these dudes. Just because you have a bunch of dudes that can spit doesn't mean your record label is going to be successful, dude. This is where business and art collide, man. And this is what J. Cole has to understand. As he's going on with this partnership with damn Interscope, man, he has to work damn hard promoting each and every one of these artists so they can have their own individual careers underneath his record label. Each of them need to have their own success, and it would have helped if they were different from him. But yet, then not really, man. You can tell that they all have an influence from him and shit. And which that's not really a good thing, because all that does is siphon off his fans to go to them instead of them bringing their own fans to the damn table, man, which is how it's supposed to be fucking done. But I definitely got high hopes for this, man. I mean, these guys will be making some damn good music, I believe, man, and the mixtape is a damn good listen. Definitely recommend you guys to go ahead and download that one. But anyway, on to Ask Download Pass. And Dreadhead Dude says, in which he's talking about that Man of the Year by Schoolboy Q, the music video. He's saying, at least that video was not a bunch of dudes shirtless with no chicks around shooting pretend guns with their fingers and shit. Hey, I feel you, dog. I feel you 100%, because, I mean, that whole trend thing, man, that's kind of weird. I definitely do love me a video with a bunch of dope ass chicks. John Sharp pretty much saying that Isaiah Rashard is going to be one of those guys that succeeds and get notoriety like Kendrick Lamar did by about the time that his second album comes out, man. And I mean, one could only hope for that, man, but that's not really the norm here, dude. See, what makes you huge in the music industry, man, is the moves that you make within the music industry. How Kendrick really got the buzz, man, was he was hopping on everybody's shit and fucking murdering people. He came out with the most epic diss song of last year, dude. I think Isaiah Rashard is one of those dudes that needs the damn promotion more than anybody else, and I don't think they're going to give it to him. I think he will continue to grow slowly, man, but he's not going to be that instantaneous hot artist.